Learn how to display and label features in ArcGIS Pro. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel for another tutorial. Before you continue to watch, please take a moment to hit that subscribe button below if you haven't already done so. So today we continue our ArcGIS Pro series and we'll be learning how to display data by symbolizing and labeling. In my last tutorial, I edited using the trace tool as well as the direction distance function. So you can check that out at the top of this video right now. Anyhow, let's get into today's topic. So we launch ArcGIS Pro and open a new or an existing project. And I will add my layers to my map. That's my existing or my new map. That will be labeled and symbolized. As you can see, I just dragged my layers from the catalog window. So you can do the same. Or you can add from the add button up top. Just to note, you know ArcMap has many options as it relates to labeling and symbolizing features. ArcGIS Pro has these options as well, and maybe even more. These are all important aspects when you think about map aesthetics and readability. So in my scenario, at first I wanted a simple symbol that would represent all my utility poles. But then I changed my mind and now I want to symbolize my utility pole features using unique values based on the material attribute field. I also want to make sure I remove all other values so that when my labels are displaying, you won't see that additional all other values label. To do this, under the symbology properties, I select more and I ensure the show all other values is unchecked. I actually went ahead and edited my utility feature some more. I'll link my editing in ArcGIS Pro video at the top of this video right now so that you can see how those utility features were created. So now I want to label my utility pole using the height field. And to do this, I right-click the utility pole feature and select label. My feature automatically labels with the first attribute with the text type, but I don't want that, so I go to the labeling properties and I clear the expression and I replace it with the height field. But the number by itself doesn't serve much purpose if you don't see what the number represents. I want to add M for meters at the end of my height label. So I edit the label expression here to first add a space between my number and my unit of measurement and then to add the actual unit of measurement. In this case, M for meters. I also want to ensure that my labels don't look overcrowded on my map, so I want to turn off these labels at a certain scale. I also want to change the look of my text. So first, I go to the visibility range on my label class and I set my label to turn off when this feature zooms out beyond 1 in 50,000. Next, I go to the symbol tab under my label class and adjust my text. I want to do one more thing before I move on to my other features. I want to set my visibility range for my utility pole feature itself. So I go to the properties of the utility pole and under general, I set my visibility extent for my feature. You know that this was applied once you see the feature turned off at the scale in which it was set. And also you see the feature grayed out in the table of contents, just like it does in ArcMap. Today, we symbolized and did some simple labeling for our utility feature. In the next ArcGIS Pro tutorial, we will extend our symbolizing and labeling capabilities by creating hatched features and adding labels with multiple lines. As usual, thank you so much for watching, and please don't forget to like, subscribe, as well as share this tutorial with a friend or colleague who you believe would benefit from this information. Also, leave a comment down below to let me know how you like the tutorials or if you have any other tutorials that you would like to see. Thanks again and see you next time.